Hey everyone, looking over the news this week, I wondered if the climate protesters had been up to their usual tricks in London, but it turned out to just be the 50th anniversary of the Beatles' Abbey Road album, and a bunch of idiots commemorated it by blocking off the zebra crossing, which happens to be in a major road, while observing motorists sat motionless, wishing that fans would start recreating the latter minutes of John Lennon's life. There's also some headlines about a power outage, although on further inspection that's something to do with electricity, not the remainder powers that be losing control of the situation, as it dawns on them what I've been saying for months, which is that if nothing happens, and if Boris doesn't actively sacrifice his reputation for the sake of the EU, then the status quo is a no-deal Brexit, no matter what they say or do. The timeline of events is already enshrined in law with an approaching sense of optimistic inevitability. For them, though, it must feel a bit like when you get one of those cards from a delivery company and the depot isn't open until after the weekend, and you need that stuff tomorrow, but there's nothing you can do about it. In that analogy, maybe it's FedEx or UPS, but Jeremy Corbyn would be a mix of the two, fed up. Or at least he claims to be, on the off chance that he can call an election and get back to his favourite hobby of making spurious promises and soundbites. Honestly, I think if I had to listen to him stand in Trafalgar Square giving a speech, I'd probably just lie down and cover myself with birdseed. It'd be more fun being pecked to death than putting up with that. Nonetheless, there are now legitimate commentators talking about three or four Labour front benchers giving up their vitriolic anti-monarchy work online to visit the Queen herself and ask nicely to sack her new PM and appoint them so they can beg the EU for an extension to Article 50. Is at this stage that you realise that Corbyn is less like Tito, the authoritarian dictator of Yugoslavia, and more like Tito out of the Jackson 5, a figure of fun, of entertainment value, and yet at the same time a sideshow while the main act is going on elsewhere. The craziest part of it all is the idea that a Corbyn government would even have the support of the Labour Party, many of whom despise him, or indeed want to stop Brexit in the first place, given how most of his hard-left policies are completely illegal under EU law anyway. All as part of the EU's policy of eventually making all nation-state laws illegal, I guess. Anyway, see you next week. If you like these, please subscribe.